If you look at universities around the world that are under 50 years of age, it's incredible the global reach that's happened at UIC in a very short amount of time. UIC really mirrors the global city that Chicago is.
I'm a member of a team of scientists at the CERN laboratory in Geneva, Switzerland, working to discover the fundamental properties of matter and space and time in nature. We're studying fundamental questions about nature which are so challenging to answer that no single university, no single laboratory, no single country can marshal together the resources or the knowledge or the know-how to answer these questions. It's only by collaborating globally and internationally, bringing knowledge from all parts of the world together, that we can tackle these questions. We're learning not only about the fundamental science of how nature works, I think we're learning about how humanity can work together. The transformative nature of scientific collaboration, I think, has implications, much broader implications, for how we as humankind can work together.
In Laos, medicinal plants are the backbone of primary health care because modern pharmaceuticals are difficult to get. Or if they are available, the cost is very high, beyond the reach of most of the general population. The healers use these medicinal plants to treat diseases. We have been studying medicinal plants of flowers since 1998, and we discovered compounds of these plants that kill cancer cells, the virus of AIDS, parasite of malaria, tuberculosis bacteria. So the goal of the research really is to discover new bioactive compounds with potential to be developed into new pharmaceuticals.
I grew up loving the ocean, and when I attended college, I studied the chemistry of living organisms. And here at UIC, I'm able to combine these passions. So the focus of my laboratory is to explore the world's oceans and collect all the bacteria that live there. And we're going to use the chemical weapons that these bacteria produce to fight infectious diseases.
We are developing new sensor technologies for monitoring of bridges. This is a 64th scale of a cable stayed large structure in Chongqing, China. And this particular bridge is called the Twin Rivers Bridge. It goes over a river by the city. Placing sensors on this particular structure is an expensive adventure. We have developed one line of optical fiber. This one line of optical fiber does the job of 10,000 sensors.
Psychiatrist Oloshala Ajilori uses Cave 2 to analyze brain scans. He's looking at bundles of nerve fibers to see how damage to these tiny structures might lead to depression.
So it's been really exciting to be able to visualize the fibers, walk around the brain, look under, between fibers.
This is a kind of visual instrument to help the human brain make sense of large amounts of data.
My research at UIC focuses on everyday market practices. For 20 years, I've worked in global markets in 5 continents, including sub-Saharan Africa. Africa's population exceeds 1 billion, and over the next 4 decades will surpass India and China. Multinational corporations are now racing to participate in the renaissance of African markets. Still today, microenterprises drive the continent. Because microenterprises represent 97% of all African businesses and contribute to more than 50% of GDP, they are a vital source of employment and poverty alleviation. Recognizing microentrepreneurs are key change agents, in 2005 I founded and built an engaged research initiative, the Masazi Visitor and Welcome Center in Ghana, West Africa. Masazi aims to contribute to the economic growth of the marketplace vendors, to facilitate interactions between global buyers and local sellers, and to promote positive perceptions of and responsible investments in African countries.
We have made transformative impacts all over the world. what we learn across the globe, we bring back here to our university. We become better people, teachers, researchers, better scholars. And you can't go into a global arena thinking you have all the right answers. You have to be open-minded. And when you bring that type of outlook back to the university, we are a better place.